Mina, kanbanwa, Jesus Freaking Gamer here. Hopefully the mic is behaving. I tried to get it fixed today, and I contacted Blue, the makers of the Blue Yeti, so I'm, and I, they told me kind of some tests to run, didn't finish running them, so I don't know if it'll work. I hope it does. If it doesn't, please forgive me in advance. We're going to Joshua chapter 15, and there are a few specific things I could point out. But I'd actually rather focus on the overall chapter. This is one of those chapters where you read and you're just like, why is this in the Bible? This doesn't help me at all. So I want to take a chapter like this. Now I want to focus on the main point and just kind of give you some thoughts that maybe they're not completely worthless after all. Maybe God knew what he was doing when he put them in there. Just to give you an idea of what this chapter is about, I'm going to start at verse 33 and read just a little bit. In the lowland, Eshtaol, Zora, Ashna, Zanoa, Enganim, Tapua, Enam, Jarmuth, Adulam, Soko, Azeka. Now, Noah was not speaking in tongues. The translation there is it's a bunch of cities in the lowland of Canaan where Joshua and the Israelites had conquered. This entire chapter is detailing the boundaries of ancient Israel. And that really doesn't have a lot of importance to me or you or anyone, probably not even most pastors out there, unless you know the geography of Israel, or unless you're interested in the geography of Israel, really doesn't help you very much. But this is the promised land that God chose to give to his people. And through the Bible, we know exactly where they were, what the boundaries were. Paleontologists have ways and methods of digging up stuff and finding things and determining things, and ancient language translators, once the paleontologists have unearthed ancient documents, they can read those ancient documents and those ancient stone writings. Instead of like this, I guess it's more like this, huh? But yeah, so this part of the Bible really doesn't mean much to me, probably doesn't mean much to you. It means a whole lot to those very specialized people who will look into the Bible, and they can actually find out where these locations were and draw up all of those maps that are at the end of most of the Bibles out there. Someone uses this information and takes it very, very seriously. So it is specialized. It's not for everyone, but it is very, very important. And that goes for the genealogies. That goes for basically any other section of the Bible that's not specifically designed to encourage or exhort you or give you some kind of divine truth. It's just a bunch of locations. One other thing it does, it shows that the Bible's a real book. It's not just some fantasy fiction made-up thing where God's doing cool things in this cool place. No, we're talking about planet Earth here. We're talking about real locations in this reality, in our history. It makes it, that's one thing that me and you can take away from this. It's real. It's in this world. It's not Middle Earth or some other far off land that doesn't relate to any one of us. It's our world and it's real history. So at the very least, we can get that much from these weird little specialized portions of Scripture. Thank you guys very much. I love you guys. God bless.